Welcome to DWBI Adda channel. Please subscribe for latest training videos.
Hi everyone. Today video tutorial is about Apache Maven snapshot. So here we are going to see what is a snapshot. Snapshot is a special version that indicates a current development copy. So here you can see, unlike a regular version, Maven can check for a new snapshot version in a remote repository for every build. So here we can see that snapshot, whenever you are going to develop a project, after completion of the project, it will be in a beta version. After that, the original version will be deployed. So here the snapshot, we will call it as, while working in a project, we will be creating a copy of the project. That we will call it as a snapshot. So for each and every module or for each and every phases, we will be giving a copy of the particular project. Here in Maven, the snapshot versioning can be done using the library files. So let's see how the snapshot is created for a project. Open Eclipse file, open a new Maven project. So create a simple project, give the group ID, artifact ID. So next you are going to give your artifact ID, that is nothing but your project ID. And next you are going to give your snapshot version. So whatever version you are creating, for example, if it is a second phase, you may keep 2.1 or 2.2, like that. According to your project detail, you can keep your snapshot version. Next, you can see here packaging, it is default jar. If you want, you can choose it as WAR or other type of packaging, because the snapshot will be packaging in a particular file format. Next, you can give your project name, finish. Here you can see your project is being created. Maven snapshot project is created. You can see the packages, four packages and the POM XML file. Open your POM XML file. You can see the group ID, artifact ID, version name. So here, this for this only we are going to create a snapshot, that is a copy of a project. So here you can see the main Java package. In this I am going to create a Java class. So give the class name, then choose your main method, finish. Here you can see the class name Java example and the main method. And here you are going to write a simple Java program. So here you are having a jar files and I am going to write a simple Java program like Maven demo. So Maven demo for snapshot. So this, it will be printing in the console. Now you have to select your class and you can give run as Java application. Here you can see the class and select OK. You can see it is executed Maven demo for snapshot. Now you can come to your source and the target, nothing is available. Just like a previous, it is seen. Now we are going to add the dependency for snapshot creation. Open your POM XML file. Here, after the name, just give your dependency code. So you want to give dependencies, inside that dependency After that, you have to give group ID. The group ID is org.apache.commons. So this is a group ID, and artifact ID is you can give commons-lang-free. Next, the version. According to the version, whatever you needed for your snapshot, you can choose. So I am choosing this 3.3.2. Now, if you have added your dependency to your Maven project, you just refresh your project. The dependency will be added in your Maven dependency folder. Now run your project, press refresh. It has refreshed, checking the Maven folder. After refreshing, you want to run your Java application. You have to select both class and a POM XML. Here you can see Maven demo for snapshot. Now you can see here in Maven snapshot, just refresh your whole project again and open the Maven dependency. You can see here commons-lang-free jar has been added. Now select your project, run as Maven install. So this will install your snapshot related jar from the repository, that is from a remote repository. So you can see here the installation has been done success for Maven snapshot. So build success. Now you can able to create a copy for your project. For that, just select your Java, run as Java application. So your test is executed like Maven demo for snapshot project executed. Now refresh your project again. Select the target folder. You can see here the details like short files, and behind, like below short file, you can see the Maven snapshot 1.0 snapshot. So here in the properties, you can see the details for the group ID, artifact ID, and this is the Maven snapshot that is created. So wherever folder you have opened your project, in that folder only your Maven jar file will be available. So it is in the format of .jar. Now check where it is available. Go to your Windows preference. You can see here the local repository. In local repository only your snapshot jar will be available. Just copy the path, paste it here. This is the path for your installed Maven library for snapshot. Choose org. Apache Commons. Inside this you can see the version 3.3.2. Here the related jar files for creating the snapshot is available. Next, if you want a copy of the project snapshot, just select the jar and look for the property, or select the project and look for the properties. Here you can see the path of the project. Just copy the path. So copy the path and paste it here. Here you can see the project Maven snapshot. Select that and the target folder. So in source folder, you will have main test and your Java class. In target folder, you will be having your Maven snapshot jar. Like this, you can able to create a copy of your project at any time whenever it is required for your project phase. So this is how you will be adding your dependency and you're creating your snapshot. Now I will show you how to access it from a remote repository. This is the remote repository I have said you in before session. It is mvnrepository.com. There you search org.apache.common. You can see the latest version, that is Common Lang. Just click on the link. You can see the all versions from the initial to the latest. So whatever version you need, you just click that. I've choose 3.3.2. Now you can see here the dependency code. If wherever you need, you just copy it and paste it in your POM XML. So this is how you will be doing your snapshot for your project. In next session, we can see about managing dependency. Thank you.